Hi, and welcome to UNSW, the School of Mathematics and Statistics. My name is Thomas Britz, and I'll be going through this problem here, problem number 14 in MATH3411, which is about the binary Hamming code, in particular this 7-4 code. So this is the code determined by this equation here, where we've got a matrix H with 7 columns and 3 rows. And the code words in our code are the code words that satisfy this matrix equation here. So if you look at the matrix, then each of the 7 columns are just the binary expansions of the numbers from 1 to 7. So here we, if you sort of look at it from a bit of a 90 degree angle, then you have 1 1s, 0 2s, and 0 4s. So this is number 1, this is number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. That way of writing up the matrix is very useful for error correcting, as we'll see. For now, though, we're just looking at encoding a particular message using this scheme. So what we need to do is look at the matrix here and see which of the positions are going to be information bits and which are going to be check bits. Now, given this this way of writing it up, the standard way of doing of determining those bits or these positions are to see we've got a leading entry there, there, and there in positions 1, 2, and 4. And then the other positions, they are the non-leading entries, the non-leading positions, corresponding to parametric variables x3, x5, x6, and x7. Those are the coordinates, those particular coordinates of a code word there. So what we do to encode this this message here is to assign these 4 values to these 4 variables, and then solve this equation to get x 1, 2, and 4. So x1, x2, and x4. They're the ones that we want to find out. And so x3 was equal to 1. Was equal to 1. x5 was equal to 0. x6 was equal to 1. And x7 was equal to 0 again. Okay, so let's look at this matrix equation and try to find x1, 2, and 4. So let's write the matrix up again. Hx transpose is the 0 vector. That's equivalent to saying that we have this matrix here. Times x, which is x1, x2, x3, which is equal to 1, then x4, the last of the check bits, and then x5, 6, and 7, which were 0, 1, 0. And okay, now let's multiply these out. So we have 1 times x1, 0 times x2, 1 times 1, 0 times something, 1 times 0, 0 times something, 1 times 0. We have a whole bunch of zeros. So we've finished multiplying the first coordinate. Let's go on to the second coordinate. And here we go. 0 times x1, then we have x2. And then 1 times 1. And a bunch of zeros. And then some ones. And finally, 0, 0, 0. And then the rest is 1, so we have x4 here. And then one of the ones here, Okay. Now let's just tidy it up a little bit. 1 plus 1 is 2, but we're working modulus 2. So this is actually just 0. And all of this had to be equal to the 0 vector. So we can write that up. So now we know that x1 plus 1 is 0. So mod 2, x1 has to be equal to 1. X2 has to be 0. And x4 has to also be 1. And there are our check bits. Okay, so now we can encode this word as x. It's equal to x1, which was 1. X2, which was 0, x3, which was 1, from there, x4, which was 1, x5, which was 0, and then 1 and 0, and that's our encoded word. So here we have 1, 0, 1, 0, being the original message, and then 1, 0, 1, being the check bits. So 3 check bits and 4 information bits. Okay, now in part B, we have to correct this received message and then decode it to get hopefully the original message, assuming that there's only at most one bit error. So what do we do? Well, we just calculate the syndrome of this word. So we have S of y, which is equal to the h of y transpose. And if you calculate that, well, yeah, here we're just working with binary numbers, so everything is really simple. We've got a 1 in position 1, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we're just taking when we're multiplying this vector onto this matrix, we're taking those corresponding columns, so 1, 4, 5, 6, 7, taking those columns and adding them to each other. And that's a quick shortcut to get the result. So this is 1 and 0 and 0. Okay, so first of all, we note that this is not the zero vector. So there is some error. If we assume that there's only exactly one bit error, then we can just go to our matrix and see what column vector is this one? What's its position? And we look here and, there we go, it's the very first one. That's the way we do it in general. In this specific case, where we've ordered the columns, or we've chosen these columns so nicely, we can actually just read off which column it is. This one represents its own position. It's just the number 1. So apparently there's an error in the first position. So this 1 here has to be corrected to a 0. So the corrected code word is then, let's call it x. That's 0 instead of the 1, and then 0. 0, 1, and a bunch of 1s, 1, 1, 1, and there we are done. So this is the corrected code word. There was one error right in the first bit. Okay, we also have to decode this code word, and that's very easy. All we have to do is look at the information bits, x3, 5, 6, and 7, these green ones, if you can see that, and just extract them. So we have these green ones here, 0, 1, 1, 1. So the decoded message is just 0, 1, 1, 1. So we just ignore the 0, 0, 1 check bits. And this is hopefully our original message that was transmitted, or encoded and transmitted. Okay, thank you very much.